嚟到最後一個 structure 咧，就係、有關於giant metallic structure。其實呢個咧就比較簡單嘅。咁但係倒翻轉咧，你要需要注意嘅咧，就係佢嗰個結構上面嘅一啲分別。咁你可以先望下先。咁啊，giant metallic structure 咧，其實所有嘅 metals 啦，無論係得一隻 metals 或者係有好多隻 metals 撈埋一齊咧，其實佢都係 form 呢一隻咁樣嘅giant metallic structure 嘅。咁啊，請你留意啦，呢一個 giant metallic structure，咁啊有好多 cations 喺呢一度啦，咁我哋叫有好多 metal cations 啊，即係每一隻 metal 啦，其實佢都想 lose electrons 嘅，咁啊 lose 咗 electrons 出去嘅時候咧，咁佢就會形成一個 metal cation，而最後咧啲 electrons 咧就會掉咗落去成個 pool 入邊嘅，呢、這個 pool 咧咁啊周圍大家一齊 share 啲 electrons，啲 electrons 咧就。你呢個 cation 掉咗粒 electron 出去啦，咁隔離嗰個咧就接啦，咁啊接完又拋完又接啦，你可以想象一個好大個嘅籃球場，咁大家咧就所有人固定企喺度，咁跟住每個人手上面咧就揸住一個籃球，係咁喺度掟，跟住係咁喺度接，係咁喺度掟，係咁喺度接啦，OK，咁咧就係一個咁嘅結構。而呢一班人咧，點樣去維系呢段關係咧？就係、透過呢一班將啲波拋完又接，接完又拋嘅一個過程咧，就維系埋一齊。呢個真係一個 giant metallic structure。可能我哋試下睇下咧，咁有啲咩注意嘅地方。giant metallic structure 咧講到明啦，係 giant metallic 啦，就淨係得 metal 嘅啫。不過你主要咧，你要留意翻就係、between 呢啲 metal cations 啦，同埋一個 sea of electrons 啦，一個字叫超級重要啊，sea of electrons，或者人咧叫free electrons 或者 mobile electrons。咁中間嘅 attraction force 我哋叫佢做 metallic bond 啦，又或者你可以形容係一個 metal cation 同埋 sea of electrons 中間嘅一個 electrostatic attraction，呢個字咧比較深啲啦，叫做 electrostatic，OK，中文咧我哋叫做靜電力啦，electrostatic attractions，OK，一啲靜電嘅吸引力啊，OK，明啦。electrostatic attraction 呢一種咁樣嘅，雖然係拋同埋接啫，但係一班球場上面咧，中意嘅波友咧，雖然成日都係拋同接啦，但係佢哋之間嘅關係都幾好㗎。OK，佢哋之間維係得好好嘅，所以咧，通常佢哋嘅 melting point 同 boiling point 都比較高㗎。OK，咁啊，當然啦，除咗 Group One Metal 之外啦，Group One Metal 咧，咁啊，當佢哋嗰粒 electrons 咧都得一粒啦，同埋佢哋對住嗰粒 electrons 嘅 attractions 咧就比較弱啲，咁所以咧佢哋就比較 soft 啲啦。OK，咁佢哋嘅 strength usually hard and strong，咁啊除咗一隻啦，除咗 mercury 咧就係一滩 liquid 嚟嘅啫，咁佢哋你都唔可以话佢 hard，亦都唔可以话佢 strong 啊，OK，咁啊佢哋嘅 state 咧全部都系 solid 嚟嘅啦，就除咗 mercury 啫，OK，咁啊即系代表住佢中间嘅 attraction 就比较弱啲啦，好啦，咁啊跟住呢一个咧就系、是。giant metal structure 最獨特嘅地方啦，呢個亦都係超級重要啊。OK，佢係一個 conductor in both solid liquid states，in both solid and liquid states。喺無論任何嘅情況之下，room temperature 一定可以導電噶啦。OK，導電嘅原因同我背咗佢咯。呢、這個叫 mobile electrons。OK，或者一啲 free electrons 啊，你中意啦。OK，咁啊，補習老師咧會用唔同嘅字眼嘅，咁啊，mobile electrons 就好，free electrons 好，咁啊，總之記住，佢 conduct electricity 同埋 conduct heat 嘅方法都係透過 free electrons。咁啊，用唔用水咁啊，都係嗰句啦。咁啊，你唔想啲 metal 用水啦，OK，抌落水嘅話，佢用咧，用咗嘅話咧，就好多嘢都做唔到噶啦。OK，examples 太多啦，咁啊，blah blah 90000几个，咁啊，請你記住啦，最重要 giant metal structure 可以分辨到佢開嚟嘅。系佢可以响 solid state conduct electricity。第二，你可以分辨到佢嘅就系一啲 high melting point 同 boiling point。OK，同埋咧佢有两个好独特嘅 properties 噶。咁我哋叫做ductility 啦，或者 OK，ductile 咧就即系话你可以将佢硬到好扁嘅。OK，硬到好扁，变成一块薄片嘅，咁呢个叫 ductile 啦。OK，咁跟住咧，另外一个就叫做 malleability，OK，malleability 啦，或者有啲人叫做 OK，malleability 咧就即系将佢拉长嘅。咁啊，呢两个嘅 properties 咧，你需要特别去注意翻啦。咁啊呢个系giant metallic structure 咧，你要识嘅地方啦。咁咧就将四个 structure 咧就简单介绍晒俾大家识。咁我哋试下望下后面呢一个 example 啦。咁如果你可以 identify 到嘅话咧，咁就代表住你已经可以落学成下山啦。睇下第一个佢 A 咧，佢嘅 melting point 比较低嘅。咁啊，佢喺 solid state 同埋 molten state 都唔能够 conduct electricity 嘅。咁呢个系咩 structure 咧？冇错啦，咁佢就应该系一个 SMS 啦，simple molecular structure。因为喺 both solid state 同 molten state 都唔可以 conduct electricity，and 佢嘅 melting point 系比较低嘅。好啦，咁跟住个 melting point 比较高啲，响 solid state 唔能够 conduct electricity，但系响 molten state 咧就可以 conduct electricity 嘅。咁呢个系咩 structure 咧？咁冇错啦，就系呢一个 giant ionic structure。OK，ionic structure 只系喺 molten state 可以 conduct electricity，因为佢有 mobile ions。咁跟住啦，你见到你有一个melting point 比较低啲啲，但系咧佢响 solid state 同埋 molten state 都可以 conduct electricity 喎。冇错啦，咁佢咧就一定系一只 metal 嚟噶啦。OK，因为 solid state 都可以 conduct electricity 嘅，一定系 metal 咯。最后啦，你见到咧有个劲高 melting point 嘅，跟住咧佢 solid state 同埋 molten state 都唔能够 conduct electricity 嘅，咁呢个一定系一个 giant covalent structure，OK？咁希望咧透過呢個簡單嘅 practice 可以幫到你分辨一下呢四隻 structure 究竟會發生咩事，OK？咁啊呢一個 video 咧，希望又可以幫到你。